had this sense in high school I wanted to be in biology, but then by college, I still don't really see myself as a scientist. Searching for science labs and undergrad research positions, I kind of, this whole world opened up to me that it is now my whole career. Now I am a senior scientist at a biotech company in Eastlake in Seattle. And the whole company's goal is to find new drug targets for diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Without this early foundation, without this confidence boost from being a Levinson scholar, without the practice of being an undergraduate symposium, I just really wouldn't have had this amazing career that I've had so far, and I'm so grateful for it.
Mentoring students has absolutely impacted me as a researcher. I think one old insight of critical theory is that we try to make the familiar strange, and there's no better way to do that than to have these intergenerational conversations, because I'm helping them see things in a different light, and they're helping me see their reality in a different light. And so that happens on a daily basis, and I just I can't say how often I am enriched by those kind of interactions. And I think that's really why many of us come into this business, working with young people and older people, because we have all kinds of students here, and thinking about what are they going to be able to do in the world that can change it.
In March of 2020, we launched this large COVID project. The essence of the paper was that we identified a number of factors we could measure when a patient's diagnosed or even before that anticipate whether they're going to get long COVID.
As I kind of gained more experience, I was able to suggest more things that I thought we should look at, and who would provide feedback on what those directions are, perhaps what I might not have considered. As that kind of progressed more, I would present to the lab, and that's kind of where I started interacting with Jim a lot more.
You know, none of those conclusions, you know, would have been possible without Daniel working on that. So yeah, I mean, that's an impact. This is why this paper made such a big splash. Is not only have we begun to get a handle on the heterogeneity of this disease, but we actually are beginning to understand what possible treatments there might be.
What you learn in research, you know, the life of a real researcher is existing and enjoying the fact that what you are trying to learn, nobody knows. For undergraduate researchers, you know, some of them are only now discovering what they're truly capable of. The Washington Research Foundation supports the intersection of STEM research, where there might be useful or commercial applications, but also create an opportunity for these innovations to actually reach the public and serve the public good. Supporting such students gives them an enormous gift at a really important time in their life.